Hello. Good evening.
Hello.
Hello, how are you today?
No me good? Escuchan, ya viste.
Hola. Sí, la escuchamos. Ahorita la acabo de escuchar.
Tengo que salirme.
¿Por qué
no? No me sirve.
No se salga.
No entiendo por qué.
Bien cabal soy, imagínate. Okay, guys, so we're going to start with today's class. We're going to work with many different things here today. Right, let me show you my computer so we can start. We have enough people to start right away the class. Vamos a empezar ya de solo la clase. And today, well, we're going to start working with things we did yesterday with the class and things that we're going to complete today, right? Now, yesterday we were talking about what? What was the topic that we had yesterday? Mr. Ricardo Gabriel? What was our topic yesterday?
El día de ayer vimos el presente, present simple para present progressive.
Okay, yes, we saw that. That's correct.
Examples for use. Example for use. That.
Okay. Examples for that too. Yes. What else did we see? What else did we study yesterday? Only that? Can I click it? Only that? What else?
No.
No?
No, maybe. Hicimos ejercicios.
We did exercise. We completed exercises. Exercises of what? What were the exercises?
So, for example, cuando hicimos el texto de mezclar present simple and present progressive, dependiendo de cuál era la frase que estaba, del contexto que tenía.
Excellent, excellent, yes. We mix them, we combine them, very good. What else did we do, Sandra? What else did we do yesterday?
What?
What else did we do yesterday?
Yesterday.
No solo vimos el simple present. ¿O sí? No. Miren su cuaderno.
No.
Tech support.
Oh, we saw tech support. Phrases of tech support. Thank you so much, Emerson. Phrases of tech support. Okay, okay, I understand, Ricardo. Si le pregunto, no me haga caso, okay? Now, Sandrita, we saw tech support. Emerson says tech support. Angie, what do you remember about tech support?
Hi, teacher. Good evening. quiero ver.
Vea, vea, no hay problema.
ways to report a problem.
How to report a problem, huh?
quiero ver, ¿qué más? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más?
Example of the gerundio.
Examples of gerunds. Okay, sí, eso fue un plus de ayer. Eso fue un plus de ayer. Muy bien, Natalia. Muy bien. What else do we see? Carmen, why are you so quiet today?
Evening. Hi teacher, we are practice a lot of conversation between text board, and we are talking about present progressive, present simple too, making example about this topic and what all. Yes, practice the conversation too, the listening and conversation.
And the conversation, yes, that is totally right. Thank you so much. Now, we're going to go ahead and work here, right? With the information of yesterday, okay? We talk about text before, that is correct. And today we're going to finish with that topic, and we are going to also use how to use would like to, right? This is going to be our grammar topic for today. But we practiced this conversation yesterday, right? In which we were reporting a problem, right? We were reporting a problem. What was the problem here according to this conversation? Who remembers the problem? Sandrita, what was the problem?
Can you tell me noise in the computer?
Okay. Now, in this conversation, en esta conversación, ¿cuál es el problema que reportaron?
Can you tell me how low your internet has?
No, that is not the problem. Ese no es el problema. ¿Cuál es el problema que reportar?
My internet is having problems connecting.
My internet is having problems connecting. That is the problem. My internet is having problems connecting. Right? Right now, my internet is having problems. Right? My internet is having, that is the problem. What is the solution? What is the solution?
You see, you can say somebody.
Okay, I can send someone to fix it right now. That is the solution, right? My internet is having problems. I can send someone to fix it, right? Problem, solution, right? And this person, right, identify the real problem. A veces cuando hablamos a tech support, decimos, no me sirve el teléfono, pero no sabemos qué en realidad es lo que tiene. Solo mencionamos, no me conecta el internet, por ejemplo. Y uno piensa que no tiene saldo, qué es lo que pasa. Pero ya uno cuando habla, le dicen en realidad cuál es el problema, right? Your connection must be messed up, right? So we have there problems and solutions, and that's what we need to give right now, problems. Okay, we need to mention problems. Let's continue here. Since we need to mention problems, right? Look at the examples on how to report problems or ways to report problems. Now, let's see here, ways to report a problem. I would like to report a problem, easy. I would like to report a problem with my computer. I would like to report a problem with my printer. I would like to report a problem with my laptop. I would like to report an issue with my printer. I have trouble with my computer. I have trouble with my printer. I have trouble with my cell phone. Right? These are examples on how to report problems. Examples or common issues. It doesn't seem to work. It makes a strange, funny noise. It does not turn on, right? Estos son ejemplos sencillos de problemas que pueden tener nuestros dispositivos electrónicos, digamos así. Estamos hablando de tech support, soporte técnico. Aquí no vamos a hablar de problemas con dinero, no, problemas técnicos, ¿ok? Problemas técnicos. Now, these are issues that we have on the book. Now, let's take a look at what we're going to do. We are going to mention, and this is on your book as well, we are going to mention some other ways of reporting issues, okay? Now, we're going to put here the device, right? Let me put it here. Page 40, thank you, Azalea. On page 40, thank you so much. Now, for example, I have here my printer. This is the device, printer. What is a common issue that you have with your printer, Sandrita?
What
is a common issue that you have with your printer? Yesterday you told me one. Ayer me dijo un problema que usted le daba a su impresor.
Connection.
The connection. The printer connection.
Connection. Yes. Printer.
Printer connection is unstable. Okay. La conexión inestable. Printer connection is unstable. Okay, very good. That is one problem about the printer. And this is for Sandrita. Then here you are going to put the information of another classmate. Right? And here you're going to put your information. Your information. So right now, Sandrita is putting here the information about her printer. Now, Sandrita needs to ask another question about the printer to someone else. Okay? Sandrita, ask another person, do you have problems with your printer? Pregúntele a alguien más. Escoja usted quien le va a preguntar.
Alexis.
Mm-hmm. Ask Alexis, do you have problems with your printer?
What are the common issues you have in your workplace?
With your printer. Estamos hablando de la impresora.
Teacher, una cuestión. Tengo que, a lo que he entendido es que tengo que responderle, ¿verdad?
Yes, of course.
El problema que pienso yo que puede tener, sí, ¿verdad?
Entonces, no. ¿Qué problemas tiene usted? No, escuche, ¿qué problemas tiene usted con la printer? Un problema que usted le dé a su impresora.
Reset.
What?
Reset.
Reset. ¿Cuál es el problema? Dígame el problema que le da la impresora. ¿A qué se refiere con reset?
Que se reinicia.
Ah. Ok.
Ajá, pero tendría, si no me equivoco, tendría que ser la respuesta a I would like you
no
to reset.
No, No.
No.
Right now, we're just putting problems. Ahorita solo estamos poniendo los problemas. Solamente. No estamos poniendo nada más.
Ah, okay.
Solo queremos problemas.
Pero, ok.
The printer does not print.
Teacher, ¿cómo sería si la pregunta? What's the problem printer in the,
no.
in the workplace?
No, we're going to put the questions here.
Teacher.
Okay, one person at a time. Una persona
not
a la vez.
Printer.
Una persona a la vez. Primero vamos a poner la pregunta. Okay. Okay? The question that we're going to use right now. Okay, what seems to be the issue with, what seems to be the issue with your printer? What seems to be the issue with your computer? What seems to be the issue with your cell phone? What seems to be your issue with the keyboard, con el teclado, por ejemplo? What seems to be the issue with the internet connection? And so on, right? Now, here, you're going to choose different things. We choose a printer here. Podemos poner acá un laptop, a internet connection, el router, cualquier cosa que nosotros tengamos en la oficina que sea, que se pueda darle soporte técnico. Okay? Fotocopiadora, a photocopy machine. And then here I am going to put my issues with those things. Primero yo pongo los problemas que yo tengo con esos dispositivos, ¿ok? O con esas cosas en específico. Luego yo le voy a preguntar a Carmen, yo le voy a preguntar a Sandra, yo le voy a preguntar a Concepción acerca de los problemas que ellos tienen con esa, con ese dispositivo o con lo que yo he puesto acá. En este caso pueden ser totalmente distintos los problemas o pueden ser iguales. Por ejemplo, acá podemos ver que el problema de Sandra es que the printer connection is unstable. Y el problema de Alexis no es el mismo. El problema de él es que la printer se reinicia ella sola. It restarts by itself. Right? So that would be another problem. Right? Entonces, ¿son iguales los problemas? No, they are not the same. Pero acá ya tenemos más vocabulario para las conversaciones que vamos a hacer luego. ¿Ok? Ahorita solo estamos poniendo los problemas. Reporting issues. Okay. What seems to be the issue with? Okay. So, let's ask one more time. Let's do it one more time. Let's make another example. I am going to choose here. Photocopy machine. Photocopy machine.
Teacher.
Yes.
Una cuestión. Para yo responderle el problema que tiene mi impresora, tendría que haber sido my problem recent printer.
Aquí ¿sí? está, mire. Restarts by itself.
La pregunta que
se resetea y it restarts by itself. It restarts by itself. Reinicio.
O sea que a la pregunta.
¿No?
O sea que a la cuestión que me hizo Sandrita, yo tendría que haberle contestado it resets by itself.
No se dice reset. Alexis, se dice restarts o reboots.
Restart. Restart. Okay.
Okay. Good. Now let's go ahead and see the next one. We have the photocopy machine. Okay. My problem with the photocopy machine is that the paper. Listen to me first. The paper gets stuck. Right? Do you see those photocopy machines? Están sacando copias y se traba el papel.
Me copió.
Right?
Me copió.
The paper gets stuck.
Sí. Okay. Me copió.
Okay, so that would be
the paper.
The paper gets stuck. That is one problem that we can have with the photocopy machine. What could be another problem with the photocopy machine? What seems to be the issue with your photocopy machine, Carmen?
In my case, my photocopy machine is restarting. It is restarting or blocked with by the password.
It restarts or blocks the password. Or blocks the password. Is this what you said?
Yes, because each one have. Yes, because each one have a password to introduce in the machine at the device to make photocopies.
Okay, okay. It restarts or blocks the passwords. Okay. Cada uno que lo utiliza es un problema. Okay. Very good. A todos se les resetea. O se le bloquean las contraseñas. Okay, very good. It restarts or blocks the password. So that's what you're going to do. You're going
teacher.
To... Yes, Pedrina?
Este también puede ser Tectoner Run Off. Oh.
Okay.
Se acaba el toner.
Yes, the toner run off. Okay, very good. The toner run off. Very good, Pedrina. That is another issue with the photocopy machine. Very good. Now, what are you going to do right now? You're going to work right now individually. Okay, individually. I need you to choose four devices. Right? Ya tenemos dos aquí. Pueden usar esos dos. Escojan otros dos más. Okay? And write problems that you have with those two devices. Okay? And then we are going to ask another person.
Sure.
Okay? Yes, Sandrita?
The problem... The problem de red, ¿cómo se diría? Problem de red. Connecting por problemas de red.
But what do you want to say? Tell me in Spanish.
Problemas de red. O sea, que dice, cuando, como todo está conectado en red, ¿verdad? Entonces, cuando se cae el internet, entonces, o la red está fallando, dice, no connecting por problemas de red, dice.
Ok. But what is not connecting, the computers or the internet? ¿Qué es lo que no conecta, la computadora o la fotocopia? Okay. So in that case, you will say...
Usted envía una impresión. Usted manda impresión y le manda un mensaje que le dice...
Pero es en el impresor.
Okay, so you're going...
Ajá, en el impresor, no...
The printer connection is unstable. La conexión es inestable. Yes. La conexión es inestable.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Or the connection is not working. The connection is not working. Unstable is the same. For example, right now, my internet is unstable. Y los mira así todos empañados.
Okay.
Okay. Now, let's try to do it. We're going to do it right now individually. Vamos a hacer dos más solamente, dos más. Escojan acá su dispositivo, ponen su información y nos vamos a esperar para llenar la última parte. Solamente pongan el problema que ustedes tienen con ese dispositivo. Okay? And please tell me here in the chat if you, what would be a question, right?
Escúchame, corren.
Please take, take a screenshot of these answers. Take a screenshot. Okay, do you take the screenshot? Tomaron el screenshot.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, very good. Yes, I am going to call the thank you. I am going to call the attendance right now. So please bear with me a moment. Tell me when you're finished or tell me if you have questions. Okay, let me call the attendance. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa.
Present.
Thank you. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present.
Thank you. Carmen Lizeth Hernández Escobar.
Present.
Thank you. Daniela Mirgar Sandoval Aviles. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
Thank you. José Alfonso Palma, Juan Josué Hernández Hernández, Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Hello, Juan José.
Present, teacher.
Hello, Leida.
Hello.
Luis Armando Hello. Ventura Campos. María Concepción Cerón Jovel.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez. Ricardo Gabriel Varenga Ventura.
Present.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona. Jennifer Abidain López Escoto. Okay, very well then. We will continue here. Did you finish with your examples? Did you put your problems right now with the devices? Did you put the problems with your devices? Did you put the problems with your devices? Thank you, Angie.
Yes, teacher.
You finished, Angie?
Yes.
Okay, very well. What did you say, Concepcion?
El aire acondicionado podría ser parte de...
Yes, yes, good. Yes, it can be one. What is the problem with air conditioning? What could be a problem with air conditioning, Maria Concepcion?
Ahorita lo estoy formando.
Okay.
El primero antes de
hacerla. Uh-huh. Tell me when you're finished. Avísame cuando termine,
yes.
Por favor. Azalia, finish. Angie, finish. Very good. Can I listen to your examples?
Teacher.
Thank you. Can I listen to your examples, Angie?
In the photocopy machine, incompatibility with computers,
oh.
Configuration problems,
yeah.
Configuration problems,
settings issue, okay? Settings issue, okay? And that the computer is incompatible, okay? Very good. What else do you have, Angie?
Excuse me, teacher. I don't know. Understand.
What else do you have?
O sea, sería como para los dos aparatos, tanto en printer como en la fotocopiadora, en ambos. Los dos problemas similares.
Okay, the printer and the photocopy machine. Pero el printer ya lo tenemos ahí. O sea, iba a ser dos más.
Ajá. Por eso, incompatibility with computers en ambos, ya sea photocopy o printer, en configuration problems. Problemas de configuración.
Ok, pero usted iba a hacer otros dos dispositivos más, no los mismos.
Ah, ok, ok, ah, pues no. Tengo que hacer otros dos dispositivos, eso no entendí.
Yes.
Ok, ok.
Pero guarde ese vocabulario que acaba de crear. Guarde ese vocabulario que acaba de crear.
Lo tengo escrito. Thank you, teacher.
Very good. Azalia?
Yes. Keyboard.
The keyboard, ok. The keyboard, very good.
Keyboard.
The keyboard, right?
And okay. The keyboard does not work case.
Does not work case. What is case, Azalia? ¿Qué es case?
Que no funcionan las teclas.
Okay. Okay, the keys, let me put here, the keys, las teclas, the keys in the keyboard don't work or don't function. ¿Se pueden decirlo? ¿No sirven o no funcionan?
Don't work.
Don't work. No funciona. Or don't function.
Okay. He's not connected. Está conectado. Ese es el otro problema.
Okay. It is not connected with what? With the computer?
It is not.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, it is not connected, but when you go there, you just connect it, okay? It is not connected. So maybe it is not set up with the computer. It is not set up with the computer. Cuando algo no está, cuando ustedes, por ejemplo, ponen unos audífonos, right? Ponen unos audífonos nuevos a la computadora, hay computadoras que le piden que ustedes lo configuren, right? Si no, no funciona. Entonces, it is not set up. Okay? Y eso funciona para mouse, para keyboards, para headsets, para cualquier otro dispositivo que ustedes le agreguen a la computadora. Para bocinas que ustedes le agreguen, it is not set up with the computer. Okay? Set up.
Okay.
No está configurado. Very good, Azalia. Excellent job. Carmen. Not yet?
Yes, yes. In my case, the laptops, my laptop seems doesn't work because it has a blue screen.
Oh, okay. My laptop has a blue screen. Voy a escribir acá para que todos vayamos obteniendo el vocabulario de nuestro compañero. My laptop has a blue screen.
Yes.
Very good. Probably it's a virus. My laptop has
a blue screen. Probably it's a virus, and with my cell phone, in my cell phone is from two because it isn't connecting calls.
Oh, it is not connecting calls. Okay. My cell phone is not connecting calls. Very good. Okay. What do you mean cash register it is stolen is damaged? The monitor does not turn on. Very good, Azalia. Very good. What do you mean, Alexis? No le entiendo el de la cash register. ¿Qué quiere decir? Dígame el problema.
Uno de los problemas es en Spanish es que se atasca.
Stop.
Muchas veces he visto que están tratando la manera de, bueno, me ha tocado irlas a hacer apertura también, que no las pueden como, se atascan, no pueden abrirse.
The cash register gets stuck. The cash registers, ahí le falta la S, the cash registers get stuck. Very good. Tell me another problem. I just have Alexis, Carmen, Azalia, Angie. What about the others?
Joe. Okay. My computer don't take the password.
Oh, my computer doesn't accept the password. Ni la mía que se le agarra. My computer doesn't accept the password. Okay, very good. That is actually a problem, okay?
Y en el teléfono aparece en la pantalla desconectado, pero no sé cómo decir aparece.
Appears.
O mensaje, no sé.
Appears. Appears.
Appears. Aparece. Disconnected.
Ahora dígamelo todo.
My telephone appears disconnected.
Appears disconnected. Okay, my telephone appears disconnected. Very good. Now, these are examples that we're putting here for our devices. Very good. My computer does not save the files. Okay, my computer solamente ocupe o it o my computer, Abigail, porque si no está utilizando dos sujetos. Okay. My computer does not save the files. Ya no tiene memoria. Okay, good. So, what are we going to do right now? In pairs, vamos a llenar la otra parte del cuadro. Okay? Vamos a ver si esta persona tiene los mismos dispositivos o si tiene unos nuevos, si tiene otros problemas. Si tiene el mismo, por ejemplo, si yo tengo con my computer, it's slow. ¿Sabe cuál es un problema en su computadora, Pedrina? The audio in my computer doesn't work. Así como. The audio in my computer doesn't work. Así como. Okay. The audio in my computer does not work. Okay. Now, you are going to put the other part. You're going to complete the other half of the exercise with another classmate. Okay. So, if I work with Sandrita, I am going to listen and look at Sandrita's example. What are your examples, Sandrita?
Por ejemplo, el mouse no responde. ¿Cómo se responde cuando se queda trabado?
Yeah. ¿Cómo dijimos que se queda trabado algo? Sí. Ya lo dije tres veces.
Stop.
Guess is stuck.
Stop.
Guess is stuck. Gets
stuck.
My mouse stop. Gets stuck. Uh-huh. Okay. So she's talking about the mouse. Okay. She's talking about the mouse, and then I can give her information about the photocopy machine or the air conditioning or something else. Vamos a compartir los problemas y los dispositivos para así obtener más vocabulario de problemas que podemos reportar, ¿ok? We're going to do that, only two. Solo compartan los que tienen, los dos que tienen, y regresamos rapidito para tener más vocabulario because we are going to create conversation. Let's do that right now, please. We're going to practice in groups of two. Let's go. Let's start in this precise moment. Please select your groups, Ricardo, Angie, and Alexis. Thank you very much. Alexis, select your group, please.
A veces me tengo que salir.
Okay, we're going to put here, Pedrina, estaba viendo la que usted puso ahí. My sí. computer is very slow when I turn it on.
Sí,
when I turn it on. Cámbiale ahí, por favor.
Sí.
Okay, please share your example. Okay. Just give me one moment. I'll be back with you, okay? Ya regreso, deme un minuto, por favor.
Mi computer, ah, sí, tor in, ah, ok, me faltó algo ahí, va. When it.
Y en inglés, ¿cómo le dijo la del audio? No lo anotó.
O sea, que no es solo poner el problema, Leida. Hay que completarla. Porque yo solo había puesto que mi computadora era lenta al encenderla. Pero ella me le agregó un is very long when I turn it on. O sea, me le agregó varias cosas. Pero, o sea, no solo el problema, ¿verdad?
No, lo que pasa es que le completó la...
Ah, me la completó la frase. Ah, eso fue.
Sí.
Ajá. Sí, porque la había dejado corta. Entonces la otra que te decía que hacer de memoria, tengo que poner my computer memoria.
Como
el libro está en las preguntas. Work with a classmate. Es que yo no lo puedo pronunciar.
Algo porque yo no tengo el libro aquí conmigo, lo tengo en mi casa.
¿El qué no puede pronunciar?
Le fallo ahí.
¿Quiere el libro en digital ahorita?
Es que Ricardo, yo le estoy diciendo.
Hola.
¿Quiere el libro en digital?
Es que no lo tiene allí a la mano.
Por eso se lo puede enviar a WhatsApp.
No tengo aquí, teacher. Yo creo que lo tengo aquí en los archivos de usted. En un momento.
Ok. ¿Cuál es lo que no, qué es lo que no puede pronunciar, Ana Sally?
No, le estaba diciendo las primeras preguntas.
Y solo es una pregunta.
Porque es sobre el teléfono, ¿verdad, teacher?
Solo es una pregunta.
¿Qué página era? La 40.
La 40.
¿Pero qué está viendo la 40? No entiendo, no estamos ocupando el libro ahorita. Solamente el cuadro del libro.
Posibles problemas.
Okay, so what are the common uses you have in your workplace? Ese.
¿Pero qué están haciendo? No estamos haciendo nada de eso.
¿Y qué pidió a teacher? Porque
lo que acabamos de estar haciendo, Salia, lo acabamos de estar explicando. Lo único que van a hacer es poner un dispositivo, el problema que están con el dispositivo, y usted después le va a preguntar a Ricardo los problemas que él tiene con su dispositivo. Eso. No estamos respondiendo las preguntas, solamente estamos poniendo los problemas.
Pero sería el teléfono o cualquier dispositivo de lo de la computadora.
Cualquier dispositivo que usted quiera. Usted me dijo, por ejemplo, el teclado de su computadora.
Eso, eso le estaba explicando a él, que eso es lo que estábamos viendo, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Pero ahorita sería de responder entonces los posibles problemas de un dispositivo. Nada más.
Solamente es. Solamente es. Eso es lo único que va a hacer.
Ok.
Y tiene 10 segundos para terminar. Okay. Sigue una mami. Voy con los otros. No hace que estén haciendo lo mismo. Ya vengo.
No, ahorita se acaba de
meter. Hello.
Hi, teacher.
Any questions?
Solo necesito saber sobre el aire acondicionado. ¿Cómo se dice de
air conditioning? Is the pronunciation.
Air conditioning.
O puede decir solamente AC.
Air conditioning.
AC, digamos.
¿Hola?
AC.
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 The AC. The AC.
Ah, AC.
The AC, the air conditioning system.
Mm-hmm. Y mire, con otro le puse, it does not work. It does not work.
The air conditioning does not work. Okay. AC does not work.
It does not work. The engine, no sé.
Escríbame porque
tiene not work and his.
Okay. Concepción, lo siento. Sí,
no, yo no tengo música, pero la escucha.
Sí, escucho música, pero no la escucho bien. Escriba el ejemplo en el chat, por favor.
Va ahorita.
En lo que ella escribe el de ella, ¿cuál es su pregunta, Silvia?
My question is, system POS, POS, ¿verdad que ya está en inglés ese nombre?
POS.
¿Es donde se cobran las tarjetas?
Ah, yes. POS.
Ajá.
Es igual a point.
Yes.
Point of sale. Okay. Point of sale. Eso significa, le he puesto en mayúscula porque se llama POS. Point of sale. Ay, sí, eso por lado tan problema. You're right. The POS, the POS.
Sí, pero for example, does not charge.
It does not charge. It does not read the credit
does
cards.
Does not read the cards.
Ajá, it does not read the credit cards.
No lee la tarjeta.
Ajá. Pero no le voy a decir POS en inglés, le voy a decir POS. P-O-S.
P-O-S. Ah, ok.
Va a decir
P-O-S.
También
okay.
The POS charges the credit cards twice. Okay. Charges the credit cards twice.
Okay.
Okay. Very good. Ese es otro problema que da. The engine does not work and it's very dirty. Very good, Concepción. Excellent problem. Very good, girls. You're doing fine. Now, We're going to go with the others. ¿Ya terminaron acá? ¿Sí?
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
Ya lo dijimos la toda.
Sí, ya, ya.
Okay, very good. Very good. So I was, let's go right now. Let's go with the others so we can practice.
Me cambiaron. Solo nosotros estamos. Ah, no, ahí están todos.
Everyone is here now. Okay, now we're going to...
Teacher.
Yes?
Teacher, ¿cómo podría decir conmutador en English? O así es.
What is a conmutador? No sé qué es un conmutador, chicos.
¿Es donde está la recepcionista contestando todo, las llamadas?
Es un teléfono. Es un IVR.
Teléfono, pero con varias funciones.
Con varias líneas.
It's like a central call.
Ajá, it's a...
Perdón,
give me a moment.
Es un IVR, teacher.
¿Me nos podría escribir en el chat?
Please. Invoice Receptive System.
Yes.
It's an IVR. It's an IVR. Let me see, NG, because that word I didn't know, commutador or PBX. Give me a moment.
PBX.
Pero es que no sé qué es un PBX.
Ok.
I don't know.
Es que, vaya, voy a explicarlo. Yo creo que me podrían entender las compañeras que trabajan como en oficina. Es un aparato donde caen todas las llamadas y ahí se transfieren a las distintas líneas y extensiones.
Planta telefónica. Se le llama planta telefónica.
Ajá, pero todos decimos como un PBX.
Esta es otra cosa.
Sí, no, Sandra.
El punto es que digamos que los problemas técnicos que se dan es que cuando se va la energía, entonces no hay teléfono, o sea, no funciona si no hay energía.
Okay,
esos son los problemas técnicos que suelen suceder en la empresa, en mi trabajo.
O sea, Ángela, es que es como un teléfono donde caen todas las llamadas de todos los teléfonos. Entonces usted las desvía a las distintas extensiones.
Correcto, pero todos le llaman como un conmutador, un recibidor de varias llamadas. Ajá.
Sí, ajá. Bueno, allá le dicen conmutador.
Exacto.
Todos llegan ahí y se desvían.
Exacto.
Y la que es telephone switch for. Ajá. Ok, that's new for me. This is nuevo para mí, chicos. Let me see. We're going to use a word from 20. Disculpen, pero no sabía eso. Right, we're going to use, it's a phone system, right? But right now we call them switchboards, telephone switchboards. Let me put it here, ya lo encontramos, mire, ve. Telephone switchboard.
Telephone
switchboard, it's in the chat. Yes, ese es su PBX que ustedes mencionan, telephone switchboard. Well, we can transfer words, we can transfer calls from one place to another. Okay, that's a telephone switchboard, right? We can transfer them very well.
Uh-huh.
Okay, thank you, Angie, for your question. For your question, thank you so much. Okay, now we're going to continue here, right? With the, well, I want you to keep in mind the different problems that you have, okay? Vamos a mantener siempre los problemas que vamos a utilizar, porque los vamos a utilizar para crear una conversación. But before we do that, I am going to show you, right, some questions, and you are going to give me possible answers, okay? Esa es la primera vez que van a ver ese tipo de preguntas y el tipo de respuestas, okay? So, you are going to try to do your best to try to guess the answer. Van a tratar de adivinar con contexto cuál sería la mejor respuesta que pueden dar, okay? Now, I am going to show you the question, and one of you is going to answer. Uno va a contestar. Todos vamos a ver la misma pregunta, las mismas respuestas, y uno va a intentar contestarlo. No importa si está bien, si está mal, vamos a intentarlo, okay? Let's go ahead and start with this. Let me show you here the first question. Right? We're going to, We have our understanding for phone calls. The first question here, it says, if you don't hear someone, which of the following is the most polite thing to say? Right? Polite significa cortés, amable. If you don't hear someone, which of the following is the most polite thing to say? Number one, I can't hear you. I'm afraid I can't hear you. What? What you said again? What is the most polite thing to say, Josué? ¿Cuál escogería usted? Which one would you choose?
Okay.
¿Cuál escogería? Aquí no sabemos, ¿ok? Entonces no hay problema si nos equivocamos. Read it. Read it for me.
Number two.
Number two.
Can you please read? I am afraid I can't hear you.
I'm afraid I can't hear you. Okay. Very well. I'm afraid I can't hear you. Very good. Todos los demás escojan sus posibles respuestas, por favor. Tomen un screenshot y vayan escogiendo sus respuestas, que al final les doy las respuestas correctas. Thank you so much, Josué. Let's continue. Did you take the screenshot? ¿Tomaron el screenshot?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Asumo que sí. Which expression is more polite? Which expression is more polite, Concepción? How many do you want? How many would you like?
How many would you like?
How many would you like? Okay, very good. Concepción is choosing how many would you like, okay? Los demás escojan sus respuestas también. Ahorita no sabemos cuál es la correcta. How many would you like? That's what she chose. Carmen, you need to ask for someone's mailing address. Which of the following is not polite? Okay, listen, it's not polite. May I have your address, please? Could you give me your address, please? Give me your address.
Give me your address.
Give me your address. Very good. Very good. Give me your address. Not polite. Okay. Which of the following expressions is the most polite? Azalia. Which of the following expressions is the most polite? How much money do you have? How do you want to pay? How are you gonna to pay for this? How would you like to pay today? What is the most polite? ¿Cuál cree usted que es la más correcta?
How would you like to pay today?
How would you like to pay today? Okay, good. Let's continue. Vayan tomando sus screenshots y sus respuestas, por favor. Let's see, Emerson. How should you check if the customer needs help with anything else? How should you check if the customer needs help with anything else? What else? Yes, one more. Will there be anything else? Are you done yet? What is the best answer, Emerson?
It's, will there be anything else?
Okay, will there be anything else? Okay, very good. Will there be anything else? And let's continue. Ricardo Gabriel, it helps too while you're speaking on the phone. People can hear it. It helps to eat while you're speaking on the phone. People can hear it. It helps to burp. It helps to whisper. It helps to smile. It helps to cry.
Okay. Déjeme. Look, no sé qué es burp.
I'm going to do this, guys, but don't repeat it. When you eat a lot, right? When you eat a lot, you burp. Yes. Like Shrek in the movie. Whoop. That's burp. They make a sound.
Okay.
You make a sound when you have eaten a lot. Cuando ha comido un montón, usted hace un burp. Yes. So what is the answer?
Yes, burp.
Burp? It helps to burp while you're speaking on the phone. People can hear it. Okay? Okay, burp. Ricardo chose burp. What did you choose, guys? What is your answer? Uy, ¿qué le pasó a la comida? Next one. What happened? Look at my computer. It's crazy. Okay. If you don't understand what someone says, if you don't understand what someone says, Sandrita, you could respond by saying, I'm afraid I didn't understand what you said. Sorry, I'm not understanding only. Afraid I cannot to understand. I can't understand anything you're saying.
No sé qué me está, si usted no entiende, dice.
No lo traduzca.
Es que la pregunta dice, si usted no entiende, es que si no, no le puedo responder porque hay que leer. Dice, I don't understand. Algunas dicen.
Okay, if you don't understand, what is the answer that you could, what is the answer that you could give? Okay.
Okay, sorry, I am not understood only.
Okay, good. That is Sandrita's answer. Very good, Sandrita. The others, choose your answer. Al final vemos las respuestas, okay?
Sorry.
Sorry, I'm not understanding only.
Two. Las dos teachers, Sandrita. Sorry, I am not understand.
Okay, Sandrita, thank you so much. Okay, Sandrita, thank you. Next one, Angie. In general, being polite requires longer sentences and questions or shorter sentences and questions.
Longer.
Longer sentences and questions. Okay, very well. Now we are going to see the answers, right? Vamos a ver las respuestas que hemos dado y ya las vamos a explicar una a una, cada frase para que las utilicemos, ¿ok? Let's see.
Okay.
Oh, we have this one. Sandra. Or Angie. Which expressions are impolite? Yeah. Mm. Huh? Yes?
Excuse me.
Which is impolite, no polite. Impolite es lo opuesto. Impolite.
Ah. Yeah.
Este es ah. Cuando le digo yes, ah. Okay, very good. Very good. And now we see the answers. Look at the answers here. Look at the answers for number 1, 2, and 3. Chequen sus respuestas, por favor. So what are we going to do here? When we have number 1, right? Usted no escucha a alguien y quiere que le repita o le diga, no le escucho, okay? I'm afraid I can't hear you. I'm afraid I can't hear you. Okay. Esa es la forma más cortés con que usted se la puede decir. También podría decirle, I can hear you. Pero la más cortés es, I'm afraid I can't hear you. Okay. Repeat with me, Josué. I'm afraid I can't hear you.
I'm afraid I can't hear you.
I can hear you. Very good. Which expression is more polite? The answer is, how many would you like? How many would you like? How many would you like? Then number 3, you need someone's address, the best answer, right? The incorrect is, give me your address. Give me your number. Give me your money. No. Eso no es polite, right? So we're going to say, may I have your address, please? That's the top. May I have your address, please? Es la más polite. Okay. May I have your address, please? Could you give me your address,
me
please?
Me too.
Right? Could you give me your address, please? Both of the answers here, this one and this one are good. Esta la pueden utilizar. Esta no la van a utilizar. Esta está incorrecta. Very good, Carmen, with your answer. Let's go with number 4. Which of the following expression is the most polite? And the answer is, how would you like to pay today? I would like to pay with a credit card. I would like to pay with cash. I would like to pay with a check. Right? How would you like to pay today? ¿Cómo le gustaría pagar? How would you like to pay today? Number 5, will there be anything else? Will there be anything else? ¿Habrá algo más en lo que les pueda ayudar? Will there be anything else? Right? Nunca, nunca, nunca en una llamada telefónica en inglés vamos a usar al final, what else? Yes, are you done yet? Okay. Si ustedes utilizan are you done yet, es muy probable que los echen de la empresa. Okay. So we're using, will there be anything else? And number 6, right? It helps to smile while you're speaking on the phone. People can hear your smile, yeah. Right? So remember, it's a phone call, the other people cannot see you, right? So you need to smile. Burp is like, if you burp while you're speaking, people can hear it too, okay? So a smile is the answer. I get some
teacher.
See?
Ah, ok. Es que a mí lo que me confundió fue la última frase que dice people can hear it. O sea, como me puede escuchar, por eso no lo hago.
Ok, porque no, lo tradujo.
No es, exacto. Can hear, hear no es. Ok.
People can hear when you are on the phone. Right. Aunque no lo estén viendo, okay.
Yes.
Ricardo, siempre lo van a escuchar. Escuchan cuando alguien de verdad está sonriendo en la llamada. Ok. Now, in 7, 8, 9, 10. 7. Just a moment, please. La 7 fue la que no nos salió, miren. Just a moment, please. How should you ask someone to wait? Cuando están llamando y los ponen en espera, ustedes quieren poner en espera a alguien. Just a moment, please. Just a moment, please. Next one. I'm afraid I didn't understand what you said. Cuando usted no le entiende a alguien. I'm afraid I didn't understand what you said. Y esto aplica no solamente en el teléfono, sino que en una conversación frente a frente. Okay? I'm afraid I didn't understand what you said, Carmen. I'm sorry. Okay. I'm afraid I didn't understand what you said. In general, being polite requires longer statements and expressions like, yeah, uh-huh. Those are impolite. Okay. Vamos a tratar de no utilizar esas expresiones cuando estamos hablando por teléfono, al menos en inglés. Okay. Ah, ah, that is incorrect. Okay. ¿Entendemos cada una de las frases?
Okay.
¿Sí? ¿No?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Carmen understand the phrases. Thank you, Carmen. The others, do you understand the phrases? Ok, asumo el silencio como un sí y seguimos con la actividad. We're going to practice right now with a short conversation, right? We are going to write a conversation reporting a problem with one device in your office, okay? One device, you are going to choose one, okay? With this conversation, you can use any of the phrases here. Cualquiera de las frases que hemos practicado hasta este momento, que hemos visto y que ya me dijeron que no tienen preguntas sobre las frases, vamos a utilizarlas también para crear nuestra conversación. Okay? The conversation is going to be short. It doesn't have to be long. Right? Yesterday we saw a conversation in the book, right, that it was very short. Right? It was a very short conversation. Do you remember this conversation from yesterday? Yes? Do you remember this conversation from yesterday?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, thank you so much. So the conversation is going to be a short conversation, okay? But you are going to use also the phrases that we have practiced today. Okay? Van a hacer una mezcla de esta conversación. Los problemas, acá el único problema que dice, it doesn't seem to work. Pero nosotros ya tenemos otros más elaborados que hemos hecho. ¿Okay? Aquí están hablando de la computer. Allá yo escuché problemas con el POS. I heard problems with the cash register. I heard problems with the AC, with the printer, with the photocopy machine. Eso es lo que vamos a cambiar acá. ¿Okay? We're going to make a short conversation. So let's start right now. Vamos a hacer combinación de esta conversación, de los problemas que creamos al inicio de la clase y de las frases que acabamos de ver. ¿Ok? Traten de incluir por lo menos una o dos frases de las que acabamos de ver para que yo vea que la están utilizando. So let's start right now. ¿Se entiende qué vamos a trabajar? ¿Se entiende qué vamos a hacer?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Ok. I assume the others understand too. Right, so we're going to start right now. But let me call the attendance first. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayor. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez. Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo. Carmen Lisette Hernández Escobar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Celia Jasmine Castro de Chévere.
No me ha mencionado.
Present.
Daniela Milcar Sandoval Avilés. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas. José Alfonso Palma Mejía. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández. Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra. Luis Armando Ventura Campos. Thank you. María Concepción Cerón Jovel. Pedrina Liliana Gómez Ortega. Ricardo Alexis present, Fuentes teacher. Rodríguez. Ricardo Gabriel Varenga Ventura. Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona. Jennifer Abidail López Escobar. Okay, very good.
Yo, teacher, no me mencionó.
Claro que la mencioné al inicio. Okay, now let's go ahead and.
Ah, pues quizá mi. No.
Ya le puse aquí que aquí está, no se preocupe. We're going to work okay, right teacher. Now. We're going to work in pairs right now with this conversation. Give me one moment. We're going to start working right now with the conversation, right? We're going to have a couple of minutes and then we will come back and role play the conversation. Let's go ahead and work on that. We're going to have a couple of minutes, please. Select your groups. Selecciona su grupo, por favor. Select your groups. Pedrina Josué, select your groups. Josué, select your group. Pedrina, select your group. Hi. Do you have any questions?
Hi, teacher.
Any questions, Emerson?
Carmen? No. Yes, we have to apply our issue in the conversation that we started yesterday.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
We're going to use okay. the issue. We can also use some of the
morning.
We can also see some of the phrases that we have seen today, right? Okay, I see you in a moment.
Tomo captura de las primeras.
De las que estaba pasando la teacher.
Sí.
Sí, espérate, me quiero ver. Sí, tomé. Pero en el teléfono. Es más fácil para ver en la compu. Muy lenta es.
Entonces agregamos una de las que ya teníamos, ¿verdad?
De hecho,
originalmente se llamaba. A ver si podemos agregar.
Do you have any
questions?
No, no, Tichi. Ahorita.
Any questions, Celia and Angie?
Teacher. Digamos que en la conversación, en el problema que tiene Roberto en la conversación, it doesn't seem to work. Nosotros ahí podemos agregar el problema del printer y la fotocopiadora, ¿verdad? The paper gets
escoja uno.
Printer connection in the. Okay.
Escoja solo uno.
Okay. Va. Solo de esa, ¿verdad?
Voy a hacer uno usted con ese y el otro lo hace con el de Celia.
Ok, teacher, gracias.
Ok.
Entonces, Celia, así sería.
Sí. Yes. Está pues siguiendo después de Paper Room.
Paper Room. I see. Veo, I see let,
ahí podemos poner como remove the pap de paper and restart, como remover el papel y reinicie.
Ajá.
Como la solución.
Ajá.
Ajá.
El
remove paper. Ajá.
Ok. Entonces la conversación quedaría como tal, solo agregamos al problema, a ese problema, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Vale. Pero pueden usar de las frases que acabamos de ver.
Ok, vamos a ver. Celia.
De las que acabamos de ver, ¿cuál entra?
How would you like to do? Help, podría ser ayudarme.
How would you like to?
Ahora tenemos arriba. How can I you help?
How would you like to help today?
No, ¿qué quiere decir?
Podría ser.
¿Qué es lo que quiere decir?
Podría ayudarme.
Okay, pero esa es la que tiene al inicio. How can I help you today? How can I help you today?
Ajá.
¿Puedo ayudarte
esa
hoy?
Esa la tenemos al principio.
Esa la tiene al inicio. How can I help you today?
Ajá. Ok.
Sí, esa ya está. Así es. How can I help you today?
Ok. Buscamos otra, Celia.
Yes. Hello.
Casi no le escucho.
Ricardo, do you have any questions?
Hola.
Do you have any
varias
questions?
Varias, teacher. Porque varias, le digo.
Ok, ¿cuáles son?
Pero aquí estoy saliendo. Lo que pasa es que, vaya, de las frases que usted puso, vamos a tomar para hacer una conversación.
Pueden incluirlas en el ejemplo de conversación que les mostré del libro que practicamos ayer. ¿Ayer?
Sí.
Practicamos una conversación corta.
Pero... ajá, el que hicimos.
Pero no tenemos.
Ajá, esa conversación corta siempre vamos a tomar el contexto que, digamos, estamos haciendo una consulta sobre su tech support y ahí podemos incluir las frases que usted nos puso.
Una o dos frases incluye. E incluya uno de los problemas que ustedes ya escribieron.
Sí, es por número dos.
Por ejemplo, Concepción escribió problemas acerca del air conditioning. Okay. Entonces, en la conversación, el problema que le muestra es about the computer. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. Ese es el problema de la que quieren reportar. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. Right? Entonces, ustedes esa parte la van a cambiar con los problemas que ustedes ya escribieron.
Ese es el problema que está en la conversación.
Ese es el de la conversación. Ustedes,
por ejemplo, por ejemplo, de AC.
De AC, exacto. Usted va a cambiarlo por el AC. Es correcto. Entonces, ya cuando usted lo cambia con el AC, ya usted va agregando ya lo que usted ha creado hoy. ¿Ok?
Ok.
¿Cuál era su otra pregunta? Pero me dijo que tenía varias.
Okay. Sí. Lo que pasa es que no todas gracias. Concepción me ha hecho el favor de mandarme unas cuantas. Seis. Entonces, sobre esas seis, lo que pasa es que cuando estábamos hablando, yo estaba haciendo otro lado aquí en la cuenta. Entonces, sobre esas es que vamos a...
Sí, pero escojan solo una.
A usar. Oiga.
Estoy en uno que dice que
estamos. Sí, escojan una y con esa trabajan.
De acuerdo.
Sí. Perfecto. See you in a moment.
Ok. ¿Qué
dice?
Hello, Sandra and Abigail. Do you have questions?
La respuesta, teacher. Por ejemplo, la llevamos así. Good morning, my name is Sandra, assistant tech support. What seems to be the issue with your computer? Usted me responde, Jennifer, my computer does not...
¿Pero cómo sabiste que ella tiene... Paper... Escúcheme, ¿cómo sabiste que tiene ella problema con su computadora si no le ha dicho todavía? Usted solo contestó el teléfono. Ajá, no puede saber usted que ella tiene problema con su computadora.
En el supuesto que yo estoy respondiendo una llamada.
Por eso, usted está respondiendo una llamada, pero usted no tiene manera de saber cuál es el problema de Jennifer hasta que Jennifer se lo dice. So you go and you go like this. Okay. Hi, thank you for calling Tech Support. This is Sylvia. How can I help you?
Entonces no le puedo preguntar directamente.
No le puede decir cuál es el problema con su computadora porque usted no sabe que tiene, qué tal si no es con la computadora y es con una photocopy machine.
Ajá.
Exacto.
Entonces, asistente y support, can I help you?
How can I help you? Repeat. How can I help you?
How can I help you? How can I help you?
Excellent. How can I help you?
How can I help you? How can I help you?
Very good. See you in a moment.
Okay. Así, ¿verdad? Sí. Gracias.
You're welcome. Bye.
Problema, pero tenemos que mencionar cuál es el o sea, ¿con qué es que tenemos el problema? Sí. Teacher, tenemos una duda.
Dígame.
Es el diálogo el que vamos a hacer, ¿verdad?
Sí.
El diálogo del libro.
Exacto. Solamente
entonces,
vamos a
ir cambiando frases. O sea, por ejemplo.
Ok. Manda. Sí, va a ir cambiando frases. Va bien. Va a ir cambiando frases o va a ir agregando frases de las que ya tiene acá, ¿verdad? Y ahí en el libro ya le da un problema y un dispositivo, ¿verdad? Con my computer. Y el problema es, it doesn't seem to work. Pero ustedes tienen problemas más bonitos, más elaborados, que ya escribieron. Okay. Ya las dos ya tienen por lo menos 3 o 4 problemas. Entonces, no vamos a utilizar eso porque ya sería muy repetitivo. Van a utilizar los suyos.
Correcto.
Okay. Utilizan los suyos.
Pero si vamos a guiarnos como con el mismo diálogo, ¿verdad?
Exacto, exacto.
Entonces, entonces lo que yo le decía ahorita a Sally, o sea, si le vamos a poner I did like to report a problem, en este caso, en lugar de poner with my computer, le vamos a poner with my keyboard, por ejemplo, que es lo que puso Azalia, ¿verdad?
Exacto. With my keyboard. Keyboard. Repeat. Keyboard.
With my keyboard. Entonces, ya después le dice, entonces, y en lugar de ponerle abajo donde dice it doesn't seem to work, le vamos a poner, en este caso, ¿qué puso usted? ¿Cuál era el problema, Azalia?
He's not connected.
Entonces, cabal, le ponemos he's not connected.
Okay.
Bye.
Keyboard does not work case. Que luego dije the case in the keyboard don't work.
The keys in the keyboard. Repeat. The keys in the keyboard don't seem to work.
The keys in the keyboard don't
seem to work.
Work.
Oh, don't function. Very good. Very good. Any other question?
It's not set up.
¿Alguna otra pregunta?
En el caso de cuando le pregunta. Sí, teacher, yo. En el caso del diálogo, o sea, vaya, por ejemplo, ya le pusimos, ve ahí que tiene problemas con el keyboard. Entonces, le puede preguntar, en este caso, el de soporte técnico, what is the problem o what is the issues?
Yes. What seems to be the issue? What seems to be the problem?
Ah, okay.
Very good. Very good. So I will see you in a moment, right? I'll see you in a moment. We're going to see other group. Did you finish your conversation?
Sí.
¿Cómo quedaría?
Yeah. Según nosotros, sí.
Según ustedes, sí. Can I listen to your conversation?
Vaya. Según nosotros ya terminamos.
Okay, may I listen to it?
Copy.
Solo la copia, okay.
Vaya, hemos dejado igual.
Igual, ¿por qué igual?
Yo la quería copiar, pero igual las primeras dos, como dice. No, porque usted
le agregamos
como referencia.
Y que le agregáramos por lo menos 3 de las otras que ya habíamos visto a la conversación, así sí.
Ok, ¿puede escuchar su conversación?
Vaya, lo hacemos. Vaya, empiece usted, le sigo yo.
Dice, good morning, this is Pedrina, Frontier Support, how can help you?
Leida, Leida, I am calling for take un recurso de part, I like to report a problem with my computer.
Okay, I want you to repeat.
Wait. Just a moment, please. What is it, Pedrina?
Ah, a computer does password.
Okay, computer. Repeat. Computer, no. Computer.
Computer. No, computer.
computer does pass. Does password.
¿Qué es does password? ¿Qué quiere decir does password? ¿Qué me quiere decir el con does password?
O sea, la la contraseña.
¿Qué pasa con la contraseña?
Para entrar a la compu. Este, da problema.
Ok, Leida sabe cómo decir eso porque ya se lo dije a ella. ¿Cómo se dice eso?
Sí, sí. Creo ahí que la hice mal.
Ahí lo puse en el chat para que lo vieran.
Yo no tengo. Doesn't take the password.
Doesn't take the password.
No, aquí está arriba.
Doesn't take
or doesn't accept the password.
The
necesito que por favor tomen en cuenta. Sí, tomen en cuenta las frases que pongo en el chat también para que las utilice. Okay.
En el lesson.
My computer doesn't accept the password.
My computer doesn't accept the password.
Okay, yes. Sí. We're going to go with the others. Tienen un minuto para terminar, okay? Okay, did you finish your conversation? Did you finish your conversation? Yes, very good. Excellent. Glad to hear that. Josué, did you finish your conversation? Yes, good. Very nice. Very nice. Glad to hear that. Now, we're going to listen first to Carmen and Emerson, right?
Okay.
Let's
listen. Good morning. This is Carmen. Okay. Good morning. This is Carmen from Tech Support. How can I help you?
Hi, Carmen. This is Emerson. I am calling from the Human Resource Department. I'd like to report a problem with my cell phone.
What seemed to be the problem with your cell phone, Emerson?
My cell phone doesn't connect to the internet.
I see. Let me ask you some question. Did you check your phone data plan?
No, I didn't.
Okay, just a moment, please.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, excellent, very good. Easy conversation. Ese era el propósito de la conversación. Muy bien. I just have a question. Did you say internet or ethernet? Because we have two things, internet or ethernet. We can say it like a British English, you know, to make it easier. In American English, we're going to say internet. Okay, in American English, we say internet, and British, we say internet. Internet. Si les sale más fácil decir internet, digan internet. Okay. Internet. Okay, very good. Very good. Thank you, Carmen. Thank you, Emerson. Great job. Now, let me listen to Ana Gabriela. And who was with you, Ana Gabriela?
Azalia.
Okay, Ana and Azalia. Very good. Let's listen to them.
Okay. Good morning. Is Peter from Tech Support? Azalia.
Sorry, I am not understand only because the problem with the connection.
Hi, Peter. This is Robert. I'm calling from the administration department. I'd like to report a problem with my keyboard.
what seems to be the problem with cable?
The key in the cable don't work.
I see. Let me see the problems.
Hasta ahí llegamos, teacher.
Very good. We have a good conversation. Very good. You just need to sound like more like you're on the call, right? Hello, what seems to be the problem? Okay. Very good, Gabriela and Azalia. Now I need other volunteers. Volunteers. Voluntarios.
Hi, teacher.
Okay, Alexis. And it's going to be Alexis and Juan Josue, right?
Yes. Bye.
Okay, let's listen to you.
Okay. Good morning. This is Alexis for today's support. How can I help you?
Hi, Alexis. This is Juan Josue. I am calling from Maynes.
Which is the problem?
The scan appears incomplete the picture.
Okay, Juan Josue. Clean the glass and restart the scanner.
It worked. Thanks for the help, Alexis.
Finish.
Okay, very good. It's working. Repeat, it's working. Thanks for the help. Very it's good. Working. So Alexis solved the issue. Very good, Josue and Alexis. Good job. I would like to listen to one more. Who wants to participate?
Sorry.
Thank you, Alexis, for your participation. ¿Alguien más que quiera participar? Nobody?
Celia.
Okay, Angela and Celia. Okay, very good.
Good morning. This is Celia for the support. How can I help you today?
Hi, Celia. This is Angie. I am calling from the Human Resources Department. I did a report problem with my printer.
What it is, Angie?
I printed the paper gets to end the restart.
You call remote paper and restart it?
Yes, thank you very much. Hi, Celia.
Thank you.
Okay. Finish, teacher.
Very good, very good. Thank you so much. Very good. And now we're going to continue here with another thing. With the conversation, right? That was only an example. Eso es solo como el inicio de la conversación. Si se fijan, no estamos yendo más allá de la conversación, sino que solamente tenemos, estamos reportando el issue, right? Reporting the issue. So let's go to page 42 on the book. Let's go to page 42 on the book. And on page 42, we can see a conversation in which we are reporting a problem, right? And let's see, they give more information there, right? This is another type of conversation. I would like to listen to Carmen and Gabriel. Carmen, you're Maria. Gabriel, you are Mike. I think Gabriel is not here.
Okay.
Good.
Hi, Mike, right?
Yes.
Mike Hernandez, it's department, IT department.
Hello, Mike. This is Maria Ochoa from accounting. I would like to report a problem with my printer.
What is the problem, Ms. Ochoa?
It doesn't seem to be working and it's making a strange noise.
Is there a message in the control panel?
Yes, it says service. Also, there is a red light on the hero button. I would like you to come soon to check it.
I see. I'll be there right away.
Right away. Very good. Right away. Excellent. Excellent job. Now, with this, I want you to pay attention to the conversation because in the previous conversation, we stopped with this, right? Aquí paramos en la otra conversación, right? We stop in the middle when we report the problem, right? Report the problem. But here, we start asking questions. Start asking. In the telephone word, we say, start asking proving questions. Usted le va a empezar a preguntar a la persona a la que le está ayudando preguntas para saber qué está pasando en realidad. Okay. Is there a message in the control panel? Right. Usualmente las personas de IT ya tienen experiencia trabajando en cualquier tipo de situaciones de problemas que se les presentan, entonces tienen o tienden a preguntar las preguntas correctas. Y es de, ah, yo creo que tal vez esto puede tener. Right? But after you have reported the problem, where do we report the problem? What is the problem in the first part? Esa es la primera parte. What is the problem in the first part? Azalia. ¿Cuál es el problema que están reportando?
With my printer.
Okay, that is the device. And what is the problem with the printer?
It doesn't seem to be working and it's making a strange noise.
Very good, very good. So we have the problem there, very good. And here, right, what is the real problem? What are the, after you say, this is the general, it doesn't seem to be working and it's making a strange noise. Ese es el problema en general. Luego, right, in the conversation, she is describing more and more information about the problem. It says service. Also, there is a red light on the error button. I would like you to come soon to check it, right? Ya le está dando más información acerca del problema. Right? So that's what we're going to do tomorrow as well with these conversations. Now, do we understand this second part? ¿Se entiende la segunda parte de la conversación?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, very well. Yes. Okay, I would like two more people that didn't participate before with this conversation. I would like to listen to Concepcion. You're going to be Maria. And Alexis, you're going to be Mike.
Yes. Michael Hernandez.
Mike.
It's department. Mike Hernandez, it's department.
Hello, Mike. This is Maria Ochoa from Accordion Printer.
What is the problem, Mr. Ochoa?
It doesn't seem to be working and it's making a strong noise.
It's there a messenger in the control panel?
Yes, it's a service. Also, there is a red light on the error button. I would like to come on the check.
I see. Okay. I be there right away.
Okay, I see. I'll be there right away. Very good. I see. I'll be there right away. Excellent. Excellent. But we need to practice with more pronunciation here. Right? What is the problem, Ms. Ochoa? Repeat, Alexis. What is the problem, Ms. Ochoa?
It doesn't seem to
What is the problem, Mr. Ochoa?
Okay, very good. Is there a message in the control panel?
Is there a message in the control panel?
Is there a message in the control panel?
Is there a message in the
message. Control panel?
Message.
Message. Okay, very good. I see. I'll be there right away.
I see. I'll be there right away.
I'll be there right away.
I'll be there right away.
Right away. Very good, Alexis. Now, let's continue here. I would like to listen to the last couple that's going to participate here. It's going to be Leida. You're going to be Mike. Okay. And Gabriela, you're going to be Maria.
Mike Fernandez, department.
Hello, Mike. This is Maria Ochoa from accounting. I would like to report a problem with my printer.
What is the problem, Ms. Ochoa?
It doesn't seem to be working and it's making a strange noise.
Is there a message in the control panel?
Yes, yes, it's a service. Also, there is a red light on the error button. I would like you come to some to check it.
I see. I'll be there right away.
Okay, very good. Now please repeat with me. This is for everyone. Error. Very good. Very good. Now we're going to stop here. We're going to stop here and I need you to tell me if you have any questions about today's class. ¿Preguntas acerca de la clase de hoy? ¿Preguntas acerca de la clase de hoy?
No, teacher.
No? Carmen says no. What about the others?
No, teacher.
Okay. Now, since we don't have any questions, I will call the attendance and then we're leaving, okay? Just give me one moment here. Today is March the 23rd. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa.
Present.
Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Presente.
Azalea Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present.
Carmen Lizeth Hernández Escobar.
Present.
Cilia Jazmín Castro de Chévez.
Present.
Daniela Milcar Sandoval Avilés. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
José Alfonso Palma. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández.
Present.
Leida Azucena Sorto Cuadra.
Present.
Luis Armando Ventura Campos. María Concepción Cerón Jovel.
Present.
Pedrina Ileana Gómez Ortega. Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel Barenga Ventura. Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona. Y Jennifer Abidail López Escoto. Ok. Very good, very good. So we're going to stop here. Tomorrow, we're going to practice, or we're going to work with the use of would like to. This is what we're going to do tomorrow, right? For requests, right? To offer things. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to start with this. And of course, we're going to do some exercises tomorrow as well. Now, I am going to just stay here with one person. which I don't remember the name of this person. Give me a moment. Okay, solamente me quedo con una persona a trabajar. Los otros, have a beautiful night. I see you guys tomorrow at 8 p.m. A las 8 en punto nos vemos entonces, chicos, mañana.
Bye.
Okay. Bye, bye. I'm staying only with Angie. Bye, bye.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.